The most important thing to do after you buy a brand new bike, before start riding, we strongly recommend to check all the bolts if they are tight enough, and then to grease your linkage and steering bearings. From factory, some bikes are not well greased, and riding like that can damage your whole bearing system, and that's lots of money to invest. This video will show you how quick and easy it is to grease your steering bearings. I start by removing the front wheel, also the forks and the front caliper. Now it's time for the handlebars to be taken off. Remember to loose the screw in a cross pattern. I remove also the wires that will not give me enough space to remove the handlebars. I left all controls on the handlebars, and this way will be a less work for me to do. From the upper triple clamp, I need to remove also the speedometer bracket and my hour meter. Front fender comes off now. Yes, looks like a lot of work, but trust me, it's worth it. I like to put some WD-40 on the bolts, because they look rusty. With a bigger wrench, unscrew the bolts and remove the handlebar mount. And we have also a video where we explain how to grease the linkage. Link is in the video description. When you take off the upper clamps, make sure to hold with one hand the lower end, because it can fall down after you remove the O-ring. With a little whack, the triple clamps and the lower bearing are off. Yep, looks like some water has been inside. Inspect and clean the inside, and if you feel something's wrong, the bearings kit must be changed. I like to clean the bearings with WD-40, because it's not so dry like a brake cleaner. Make sure you get out most of the old grease. I don't like what I see here, but let's try to clean the rust with some WD-40. Same process for the lower bearing. Inspect if there's any play. Like I told you, I don't like to see rusty parts, so let's try with a Scotch-Brite pad. Oh boy, that sound! Awesome, looks like new now. I use lithium base grease and make sure the bearing is fully packed with lots of grease. You will feel on your hand when the grease is between the rollers of the bearing. Let's clean the O-rings and the dust cover seal. Some Scotch-Brite pad and a WD-40 will do the trick. Grease the interiors . Mount the first rubber seal and then the dust seal. Make sure to grease the inside part. Slide in the lower clamp and don't forget about the O-ring. Then you mount the upper clamp and then tighten by hand the main nut only. Now it's time to put our bike back together. I start with the front fender and this way I can check if the system is moving freely. Slide in the front fork and make sure all the wires are in their good position. Otherwise, you will have to remove again the forks, like I did 3 times. Luckily, wasn't a live video and was cut at editing. Tighten only the lower clamps and after that, tighten the main nut of the upper triple clamp until you think it's tight. Normally, you have to check your bike manual for the torque specifications. Now, the handlebars comes in place. We like to use it in a neutral position. Finally, make sure you use some red Loctite on this screw to not get loose. Finish with the calipers and the wheel, and you're done. If you like this video, don't forget to like, share and subscribe to our channel. Leave us a comment with what you want to see next in our how-to series.